Yuck, what are those tiny white spots on the back of that guy's airplane seat? And what other disgusting stuff is left over in that seat back pocket from the previous flight? And that thing behind my head? Yikes, just imagine what is on that thing.
What exactly are those weird things? How often do they change them out? How gross is the tray table? Should you be wearing a mask because of the cabin air? And once and for all, is it safe to order coffee and tea on board? How gross is the water? We are answering all the questions about how germy your airplane ride is in this episode of Window Seat.
Admit it, it's something we all think about. Many of us try not to think about it, but we are just going to lay it all out there quickly so you can plan accordingly and bring with you the necessary cleaning supplies on your next flight. So you might think the bathroom handles or the tray tables could be the dirtiest surfaces in an airplane, but a test conducted a few years back in Canada revealed the dirtiest place on a plane is, wait for it, the headrest. Yuck. Their tests involving a series of flights across several airlines. They tested more than 100 samples from seatbelts, tray tables, headrests, seat back pockets, and bathroom door handles. But those headrests were the grossest. The test revealed the presence of Staphylococcus and E. coli. What exactly is all that? Well, Staphylococcus is a bacteria commonly found on the skin and nose. Usually doesn't cause a problem, but in the worst cases, it can cause skin abscesses, and in really bad cases, it can turn deadly if the bacteria invades your body. Again, rare, but good to know. As for E. coli, it's a common bacteria, and it's often from fecal contamination. It's sometimes harmless, can cause brief diarrhea, but a few strains can lead to severe stomach cramps, bloody diarrhea, and vomiting. So gross. Got us to wondering, how well are these things cleaned and how often are those headrest covers changed? In an online flight attendant forum, one respondent says it depends on what kind of contract the airline has with the cleaning company, but usually during turnarounds only, the most dirty head covers will be replaced. During the late evening, night, all of them will be replaced, which is part of the more intensive cleaning program applied once a day. So if you're taking a flight late in the day, stands to reason, you've got a whole day's worth of filth and grime on that thing. Fly in the morning, odds are better it will be clean. The National Institute of Health and the Centers for Disease Control actually have a checklist flight cleaning crews are supposed to follow when disinfecting the inside of a plane, and we'll post a link to those in the description below so you get a better idea of what they should be doing. Now, just how gross is that seat back pocket? Didn't fare a whole lot better than those headrests. Scientists discovered a high presence of mold, coliforms, and E. coli. So why is the fuselage often such a cesspool of bacteria? Some suggest it's because cabin crews just don't have enough time to completely clean them between flights. As you know, if you've flown lately, planes are packed, schedules are full, airlines are moving as many passengers around as quickly as possible to maximize profit. Those Canadian researchers say they spoke to a number of flight attendants and customer service reps who said there just was not enough time to properly disinfect an entire aircraft. One of the airlines put under the microscope in that Canadian study, WestJet, said their planes are cleaned daily with a light cleanup after every flight, a full cleanup every 24 hours, a complete interior clean monthly, and an enhanced hyper-focused cleaning every year. Might just be time to adjust that schedule. Now let's talk about masks. After the pandemic, very few people want to wear them, and of course at this point that's a matter of personal choice in most cases, but admit it, post-pandemic, every time you hear a fellow passenger cough or sneeze, it gives you the willies, and it probably has you wondering, should I be wearing a mask on board this flight? An epidemiologist told Bloomberg earlier this year, data from many studies supports the use of face masks to prevent the spread of COVID as well as other respiratory viruses. Masks, she said, work better to protect everybody when they're universally worn, but there's also evidence to suggest that a high-quality face mask can protect the wearer even if no one else is masking. So, yes, you may get those weird looks, people may think you're seriously stuck in the year 2020, but politics and all that other stuff aside, truth is, wearing a good quality mask can keep you from getting sick, and no one wants to be sick on their vacation. All right, last one. Let's talk about that water. Here's the thing. Yes, you should absolutely be drinking water on a flight. The air inside an airplane cabin is extremely dry. It can make you risk dehydration, and that can lead to nausea, headaches, and all kinds of other problems. In fact, one expert suggests you should drink about a cup of water for every hour you're on the plane. Just make sure it's bottled water and not the tap water. While U.S. federal law requires airlines to provide safe drinking water, a scientific study in 2019 found that many airlines were providing unhealthy water that violated government rules. rules that also require airlines to flush their water tanks 4 times per year. While the tanks do occasionally get cleaned, flight attendants don't know when or how often, so they, along with public health experts, suggest the following. Never drink any water on board a flight that is not in a sealed bottle. Do not drink coffee or tea on board because it's made with that potentially gross tap water. And get this, they say do not wash your hands with that tap water in the bathroom. Instead, bring hand sanitizer. All right, if you were hoping to make a clean getaway on your next vacation, sorry, we had to give you the dirty facts. But a well-informed traveler is a good traveler. So, next time you fly, just pack some Clorox wipes with you and a good book that will take your mind off where you're resting your head.
All right, so there you have it. Now you know just how clean your airplane ride is every time you get on board, or at least hopefully. That's it for this episode of Window Seat. I'm Jeremy Hubbard. Catch us next time right here 1 week from now with a brand new video.
In the meantime, be sure to like and share this video so other travelers can be in the know about what conditions await them on board. Leave a comment if there's something we left out. And if you'd be so kind, we'd love it if you subscribe to our channel so we can share travel adventures together. See you next week with that new adventure. In the meantime, check out one of these other videos from Window Seat.